Hello guys, welcome on my channel again. Today I would like to show you another beautiful project. This time it will be 26 inches spring doily. As you can see, our project got small flower exactly in the center, and then we've got 12 flowers all the way around. For this project I used few different colors of the thread in size number 10. For the white part you will need about 50 gram ball. For my project I am using crochet hook size 1.25 millimeters, so as I said, by using this size our project is supposed to measure 26, so sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little bit less. Is actually depends how you are crocheting. Also for this size of the thread, so for size 10, we can use bigger hook size, so we can even use 1.5 or 1.75 millimeters. It will be looks nice as well, but the project will be a little bit bigger. Our work, we have to start by making slip knot, then chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now slip stitch into the first chain to form a ring, chain 1, this is not count as any stitch, and into the ring on our first strand we have to work 12 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Eleven and 12. Now slip stitch into the first single crochet and first round we've got done. So the second round we have to start by making chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then slip stitch into the next single crochet, chain of 5 again, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, slip stitch into the next single crochet, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, slip stitch into the next single crochet, 1, 2, 3, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, slip stitch into the next single crochet, and we have to continue all the way around. So at the end we should have 12 chain 5 spaces. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 5, we have to make chain of 2 and double crochet into the same stitch as we've done the first chain 5 space. So as I said, we should have 12 chain 5 spaces. Now chain 1, round number 3, and single crochet into the same chain 5 space, so into the same as we've done chain 2 and double crochet. Now chain of 5, single crochet into the next chain 5 space, chain of 5, single crochet into the next chain 5 space, chain of 5, then into the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into the next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, single crochet into the next chain 5 space, and again in exactly the same way all the way around. So again we should have 12 chain 5 spaces. So at the end again we've got chain 2, and now instead of the last chain of 3 we have to work double crochet into the first single crochet on our round, and round number 4, chain 1, then single crochet into the same stitch. Now chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet into the next chain 5 space, and now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, single crochet into the next chain 5 space, chain of 9 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet in chain 5 space, then chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, single crochet in next chain space, and again chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet in next chain space, then chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, single crochet in next chain space. So again, we have to continue this pattern all the way around. So one time we have to work chain of 9 and next time chain of 5. So we should have 6 chain 9 spaces and 6 chain 5 spaces in this round. So at the end of our round again, chain of 2 and double crochet into the first single crochet. So the last chain 5. And now we've got next round, so it will be round 1, 2, 3, 4, round number 5, chain 1, single crochet into the same chain 5 space, and now into the chain 9 space. We have to work 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now chain of 3, 1, 2 and 3, slip stitch into the first chain. So we've got picot. And one more time, 7 double crochets in the same chain 9 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Single crochet into the next chain 5 space, and again in chain 9 space we have to continue with 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, chain of 3, slip stitch into the first single crochet, into the first chain space, and the one more time, 7 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then again, single crochet in chain 5 space, and in each chain 9 space we have to continue what we've done here. So in each chain 5 space we have to work single crochet, then 7 double crochets, picot and another 7 double crochets. So we should have 6 petals all the way around. At the end of our round, after the last double crochet, we have to work slip stitch into the first single crochet from the beginning. Then we have to fasten off and cut the yarn. And now I'm going to start with the next color of the thread. And we are going to join in any picot. So basically, we have to work single crochet into the picot. So we have to join, chain 1 and then single crochet. Now chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, and into the single crochet from the previous round we have to work basically first part of the treble crochet, so I'm not quite sure how the stitch is called, and then maybe we will work whole treble crochet and into the second part. So this is the first one, it's quite easy to see. So exactly in the middle we are going to work 2 double crochets together, so through first loop one time and through first loop second time. We should have 3 loops on the hook. Now we can finish the stitch, and we've got some fancy stitch here. And now again, chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, then single crochet into the next picot. Chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and again into the single crochet. We have to work treble crochet. And then into the second part, we are going to make 2 double crochets together. 1 through first 2 loops only. First time and last loop need to stay on the hook. We've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. So again, we've got the same stitch as here. Then chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Single crochet into the picot. Chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And again, treble crochet into the single crochet. Then 2 double crochets together into the second part of the treble crochet. So exactly in the middle. 1, 2. So now we have to continue pattern all the way around. At the end of our round, after the last chain of 9, we have to work single crochet, slip stitch into the first single crochet. And now we are going to start round number 6, 7. I think this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, round number 7. Chain 1, then single crochet into the same stitch. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Into the fifth chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 1 single crochet, chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, single crochet on the top of our 2 double crochets together. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, single crochet into the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chain stitch, chain of 6, 5, 6, single crochet into the single crochet, chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and again 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet into the 5th chain space, chain of 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, single crochet on the top of the 2 double crochets together. So now we have to repeat this pattern all the way around. So basically on each petal you should have 4 chain 6 spaces. At the end of our round I've done chain of 2 and now treble crochet into the first single crochet. So instead of chain of 4 we are working 1 treble crochet, and now we are going to start round number 8. Chain 1, single crochet into the same chain space. Now chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, then single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, single crochet in next chain space, chain of 7, single crochet in next chain space, chain of 7, single crochet in next chain space. So again, we have to continue this pattern all the way around. At the end, we have to work chain of three and then double treble crochet into the first single crochet. And we have to start round number nine by working chain of eight and single crochet in each chain space. So we had chain six, now chain seven, and one more round with chain of eight. So at the end, one more time, chain of three and double treble crochet, and then start with chain of eight. So at the end of round number nine, I have done chain of three and double treble crochet into the first single crochet, and again, chain one, then single crochet into the same chain space. So we've got round number 10 this time, and we have to start by making chain of eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, then single crochet into the next chain eight space. Chain of four into the single crochet between two chain spaces, we have to work five double crochets cluster. So we are going to make five double crochets. One, two, three, four, and five. Then we have to drop the loop, insert crochet hooks into the first double crochet, grab the yarn again, and work through first double crochet. And this is five double crochet cluster. Chain of four, single crochet into the next chain eight space, then chain of eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Single crochet in next chain space, chain of four, and again four double crochet cluster into the single crochet. One, two, three, and four. Five double crochet, so five. Now we have to drop the loop, insert hook in first double crochet, grab the loop again, work through first double crochet, chain of four. And now we have to continue this pattern all the way around. So two times chain four, before cluster and after, then chain of eight. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of four, we are going to make treble crochet into the first single crochet. So we will be exactly at the top of the five double crochet cluster. And we have to start round 11 by working chain one and then single crochet on the top of this cluster. Now chain of four, one, two, three, and four. And into the single crochet, we have to work another five double crochet cluster. One, two, three, four, and five. Now we have to insert crochet hook into the first double crochet and work through first double crochet, chain of four. Single crochet in chain eight space, chain of four again. Single crochet, and we've got again single crochet, so four, five double crochet cluster into the single crochet. One, two, three, four, and five. Chain of four. Single crochet on the top of the five double crochet cluster from the previous round. Chain of four, And from now we are going to continue exactly the same what we've done at the beginning. So we've got single crochet again, and we need to work 5 double crochet cluster. Then chain of 4 single crochet in chain 8 space and another cluster. Then single crochet on the top of the cluster and into the single crochet another cluster. So basically in each single crochet from the previous round we have to work clusters, and in each chain 8 space or on the top of each 5 double crochet cluster from the previous round we have to work single crochet. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 4 again, we have to work treble crochet into the first single crochet, and now we have to make chain 1 and then single crochet on the top of the on our cluster, then chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then we need to skip single crochet and we will work single crochet on the top of the cluster, chain of 4 and another cluster into the single crochet, so 5 double crochet cluster, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we can finish our cluster, chain of 4, single crochet on the top of the next cluster, chain of 9, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, single crochet on the top of the next cluster, so single crochet we have to skip, chain of 4, cluster into the single crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, chain of 4, single crochet on the top of the cluster, then chain of 9, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 and single crochet on the top of the next cluster. So basically on the top of each cluster we have to work single crochet, but every second single crochet we are working cluster as well. So basically we start from the cluster and we've got first, we start from chain 9, then cluster, chain 9, cluster, chain 9, so now chain of 4, cluster into the single crochet, chain 4, single crochet into the cluster, and then chain 9. And we have to continue this pattern all the way around. So again, at the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 4, we have to work treble crochet into the first single crochet. And now we've got round 13. So we have to start by making chain 1 and then single crochet into the same stitch, so on the top of 5 double crochets cluster, and then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Single crochet in chain 9 space, or if we would like to, we can work into the chain, into the fifth chain, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, it will be, looks a little bit nicer. Chain of 10 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then single crochet on the top of the cluster, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Single crochet into the fifth chain stitch of the chain 9 space. Chain of 10 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then single crochet on the top of the cluster. And we have to continue this pattern all the way around. So we have to work chain of 10, then single crochet on the top of the cluster and into the fifth chain stitch of chain 9 space all the way around. Then at the end we have to work chain of 4, and instead of the last chain of 6 we have to work triple treble crochet. So instead of the last 6 chain stitches we have to yarn over 4 times on our hook and work triple treble crochet. So at the moment just continue and I will show you at the end what we have to do. Okay, so at the end of round number 13 and at the end of round number 14, because now I am at the end of round number 14, I will tell you in a minute what I've done. We have to make chain of 6 and chain of 4, and instead of chain of 6 triple treble crochet. So we need to yarn over 4 times and work triple treble crochet into the first single crochet. So the same we have to work in both runs. So at the end of round number 13 we've done chain of 10 in each chain and single crochet in each chain space, and at the end of round number 14 we have to make chain of 11 and single crochet in each chain 10 space from the previous round. So round number 15 we have to start from the center of our chain 11 space and we have to work chain 1, then single crochet into the same chain space. Now chain of 3 and slip stitch into the single crochet. So we've got picot again, but not slip stitch, not into the third chain from the hook, but into the single crochet. Now chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, and we have to find now 6th chain stitch. One, two, three, four, five, and 6. And into the 6th chain stitch, we have to work 3 double crochets together. So through first 2 loops one time. Oh, as you can see, I've got little problem. We have to hold our yarn very, very tight. Two double crochets together. So through first 2 loops one time. Last loop need to stay on the hook. Through first 2 loops one time. Last loop need to stay on the hook again. And one more time. Through first 2 loops one time. Now we've got 4 loops on the hook. We can finish this stitch. Chain of 3 and slip stitch on the top of the 3 double crochets together. So I've done through all loops. Chain of 11 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Into the next 6th chain stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Single crochet, chain of 3 and slip stitch into the single crochet. Chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. And again into the next 6th chain stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3 double crochets together. So 1, 2 and 3 for loops, then chain of 3 and picot, so you have to work slip stitch through all loops at the top, chain of 11, 9, 10 and 11 into the next 6 chain stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 single crochet, chain of 3 and slip stitch into the single crochet. So now we have to continue in exactly the same way all the way around. In one chain 11 space we have to work 3 double crochets together, then picot, in next one single crochet and picot. At the end of our round we have to work the last chain of 11, then slip stitch into the first single crochet, and now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So now next round, so we are going to join our 12 flowers all the way around. So basically the pattern is exactly the same as we've done the first one, so you need to go back to the beginning of this tutorial and work the flower in exactly the same way. I've got my last petal and I've done first 7 double crochets. Now we have to join first flower into the picot on the top of 3 double crochets together. So it actually doesn't matter which one it will be, but we have to join to the picot when we've got 3 double crochets. Okay, so instead of working with a picot, we will work chain 1, then slip stitch into the picot, chain 1, and we are going back to the first flower and we have to work next 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So now we are at the end of our flower, we have to work slip stitch into the single crochet. Now we can fasten off and cut the yarn, so the first flower we actually joined already. And now is the time to join the second one and then each of the next 9 flowers. So the 12th one we have to join by using 3 petals, and the second, third, fourth until the 11th we have to join by using the last 2 petals. So basically we are going to join again first into the picot where we've got 3 double crochets together, and then to the one picot just after as we've joined before. So in exactly the same way, we have to work chain 1, slip stitch into the picot, then chain 1 and another 7 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, single crochet in chain 5 space, and again 7 double crochets into the next chain space, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, and we have to join to the previous flower. So just next to the petal as we've joined already, we have to work exactly the same. So chain 1, slip stitch into the picot, chain 1, chain one, and another 7 double crochets into the second flower. So to the complete our round. 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So our flower we've got done. We have to work slip stitch into the first single crochet, and again we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So each next flower we have to join exactly in the same way, only with the last one we will join 3 petals. Basically we will have to join to the 11th flower, to the main part of the doily, and to the first flower. So basically 1, 2, and 3 petals. So far we have to join again first into the picot where we've got 3 double crochets together, and then to the next petal of the previous flower. So at the end where we have to join our last flower to the main project, as I said, first we have to join 3 petals. So first one we have to join into the last flower, then we have to join into the picot where we've done 3 double crochets together in our main part, and into the first flower of this round. And now we have to start working on the border, and basically we've got 3 picots left, right, left, and the top one. We have to join our yarn into the top one by working chain one and then single crochet on the top of the petal. Now chain of 17, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Now into the next picot, so into the left one, we have to work 3 treble crochets, but basically we will work only first 2 parts, so 1 and 2, and last loop need to stay on the hook. The same with the next 2 treble crochets. We are only working through first 2 parts, 1 and 2. One more time, 1 and 2. And now we've got 3 treble crochets, but we will go straight to the first right picot on the next flower, and we have to do exactly the same. So 3 treble crochets, but only first 2 parts, 1 and 2, and again 1 and 2, and again 1 and 2. So we've got 3 treble crochets in first picot and 3 in next one, and in total we should have 2, 4, 6, 7 loops on the hook, 1 from each stitch plus 1 from the chain space. Now we have to work through all loops, and we've got 6 treble crochets together. Chain of 17 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Single crochet on the top picot, so this is the top petal, so exactly the same petal as we've joined on the first flower, this one. And from now we are going to continue this pattern exactly the same. Chain of 17, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. So into the last petal on the left side, we have to work 3 treble crochets, but only the first 2 parts. So we are working through first 2 loops, 1 and 2. Last loop need to stay on the hook. And again, 1 and 2. And again, 1 and 2. The same into the first picot in next flower. 3 treble crochets, but each time last loop need to stay on the hook. 1 and 2. One and two. One and two. So we should have 7 loops on the hook. Again, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 17 and single crochet into the next picot. And then the same pattern, we are going to continue all the way around. So at the end of our round, after the last chain of 17, we have to work slip stitch into the first single crochet, and now we are going to start round number 18. So round number 16 was with the flowers, then 17, and now we've got round number 18. So we have to start by making chain 1, then single crochet into the same single crochet as we've done slip stitch, then chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we have to skip the next 5 chain stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, into the 6th single crochet. Chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into the 6th single crochet. Chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we have to skip last 5 stitches and single crochet on the top of the group of 6 treble crochets together. And again, chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we have to skip 5 chain stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, into the 6th single crochet, chain of 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into the 6th single crochet, chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, single crochet into the single crochet. So the last 5 chain stitches we have to skip again. And from now we are going to continue this pattern all the way around. So basically in each chain 17 space we have to work 3 times chain 8 space, and we have to work single crochet in each single crochet and on the top of each 6 treble crochets together. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 8, we have to work chain of 3, then double treble crochet into the first single crochet. So instead of the chain of 5, we've got double treble crochet. And by working this way, we are in the center of the chain space. And now we can start round number 19. Chain 1, then single crochet into the same chain space. And now chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Single crochet into the next chain 8 space, then again chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Single crochet into the next chain 8 space, chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Single crochet in next chain space. So this pattern now we have to continue all the way around. So one single crochet in each chain chain 8 space and then chain of 9. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 9, we have to work chain of 4 and then double treble crochet into the first single crochet. So now we have to start round number 20 and we will work chain 1 and single crochet into the same chain space. Now chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, single crochet into the next chain 9 space, chain of 10 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, single crochet into the next chain 9 space, now chain of 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, into the single crochet after the same chain 9 space, we have to work 3 double treble crochets together. So we have to work through first 2 loops 3 times, 1, 2 and 3, last loop need to stay on the hook, and again in the same stitch, 1, 2 and 3, then one more time, 1, 2 and 3. We've got 4 loops on the hook. Now we can finish the stitch. So 3 double treble crochets together, chain of 4, single crochet into the first chain 9 space, so just after this single crochet, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Single crochet in next chain 9 space, chain of 10 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Single crochet into the next chain 9 space. So we've got 2 chain 10 spaces, the same as we've done at the beginning. And now we have to continue with chain of 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and 3 double treble crochets together into the single crochet. 1 and into the same stitch, 2 into the same stitch, 3. 4 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch, chain of 4, single crochet into the first chain 9 space. And now again, 2 times chain of 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet into the chain space, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, single crochet into the next chain 9 space, chain of 4 and one more time. 3 treble crochet, double treble crochets together into the next single crochet. So next after chain space as we done single crochet. Now we've got 4 loops, you can finish the stitch, chain of 4, single crochet in first chain 9 space. So this pattern now we have to continue all the way around. 2 chain 10 spaces, then chain of 4 and 3 double treble crochets together. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 4, we have to work treble crochet into the first single crochet. So by working this way, we are almost at the top of 3 double treble crochets together. Round 21, we have to start by making chain 1 and we will work single crochet just on the top of the 3 double treble crochets together, then chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Single crochet into the next chain space. So chain of 4 we have to skip, we are working single crochet in chain 10 space. Chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, single crochet into the next chain 10 space, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then single crochet on the top of 3 double treble crochets together again. So we have to find big loop just at the top and work one single crochet. From now we are going to continue what we've done from the beginning, so 3 times chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet in chain 10 space. So again, chain 4 in each side we have to skip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet in chain 10 space, chain of 10 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and again single crochet on the top of 3 double treble crochets together. And this pattern we are going to continue all the way around. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 10, we have to work chain of 5 and then double treble crochet. So double treble crochet on the into the single crochet from the beginning. So now we need to start round 22. So we are starting from the center of the chain 10 space and we have to work chain 1, then single crochet into the same stitch. Now chain of 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, or maybe we can work chain of 5, chain of 5 and then 3 double treble crochets again together. So exactly the same as we've done, 1, 2 and 3, as we've done 2 rounds before. 1, 2, 3, one, two, three. Now we've got 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 5, 3, 4, 5, single crochet in next chain 10 space. Now chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 10, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet in next chain 10 space, then one more time, chain of 5 now, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. On the into the single crochet, so exactly in the same line as we've done previous 3 double treble crochets together, we have to work 3 double treble crochets together again. So 1, 2, and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 5, single crochet in first chain 10 space, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, single crochet into the next chain 10 space, then chain of 5, 1, two, three, four, and five. So we've got two chain 10 spaces, and then before chain five, three double treble crochets together, and after chain five. And we have to continue this pattern all the way around. Then for the next two rounds, so for round 23 and 24, we have to repeat the previous round and the same in the same way this one as we are making now. So we have to go back and work with round 23. We have to work with chain 10 spaces, so single crochet on the top of three double treble crochets. Then we have to skip chain 5 space and single crochet in each chain 10 space. So again, we will have three chain 10 spaces, and then one more time the same pattern as we've got here. So three double treble crochets together, chain 5, and two times chain 10 space. At the end of our round, instead of the last chain of 10, yes, chain 10 space, we have to work chain of 5 and double treble crochet. So round 25, we have to start from the center of chain 10 space, and we have to work with chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and into the fourth chain from the hook. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So basically into the first after chain 5 space, we have to work slip stitch. So we've got picot. Chain of 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Single crochet into the chain 10 space from the previous round. Then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we have to skip chain 5 space, and on the top of 3 double treble crochets together, we have to work 3 double treble crochets together again. So in this big loop on the top. So 1, 2, 3. So now chain of 10 again, or maybe chain of 4 first. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we will work slip stitch on the top of this 3 double treble crochets together. So we've got picot again. Now chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then again, we have to skip chain 5 space. Single crochet in first chain 10 space. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we have to work chain of 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Into the fourth chain from the hook. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Slip stitch. Then chain of 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And single crochet into the next chain 10 space. Chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then on the top of 3 double treble crochets together, again 3 double treble crochets together. So exactly the same as we've done from the beginning. One more time, 1, 2, 3. Four loops, we can finish the stitch, and again chain of 4, slip stitch on the top of 3 double treble crochets, so we can insert crochet hook through all loops again. Chain of 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then single crochet in chain 10 space, so chain 5 space again. We have to skip. And now again, chain of 5, picot, so chain of 4, then another chain of 5, single crochet in next, chain 10 space, and we have to repeat this pattern all the way around. At the end of our round, now we have to work the last chain of 10, then slip stitch exactly in the same stitch as we start working with chain 5. And basically, that's it. So now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. At the end, to make our doily flat, we can use a little bit hot iron with a steam, or we can block this project. It's up to you. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial, and see you next time.